इट इज़ द पेज नंबर 41, चैप्टर नंबर 3, क्लीनिंग ऑफ फूड एंड द सेपरेशन ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. दिस इज द मॉडल टू डिस्कशन. नाउ इन दिस इंटरेक्टिव सेशन ऑफ दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द सेपरेशन ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस फ्रॉम द मिक्सचर. देर आर डिफरेंट प्रोसेसेस और मेथड्स विच कैन बी यूज्ड to separate the different components or the substances from the mixture or from the solution or from the suspension. And for doing this, we should have the clear-cut knowledge about the different separating method of the components or the substances from the mixture either or from the solution or from the suspension. This is the floating and the sinking method to separate the substance from the mixture. We can also separate the soluble substance from the insoluble substance. Mainly there are three different methods as mentioned in this chapter, such as in form of separation of the components or the substances from the mixture or the solution or the suspension. Such as number one is the evaporation method, second one is the decantation, and third one is the sedimentation process. These three are the process which are mainly used to separate the substances from the mixture or the solution or the suspension. Clear? And in order to understand this concept, we have to first know the different meaning of the terms, such as what is solute, what is solution, what is solvent, what is the process of decantation as well as sedimentation, what is the sediments, what are the soluble particles and what are the insoluble particles, what is the evaporation process. These are the things. These are things we are going to deal in this interactive video session. First, I would like to start from the floating and the sinking method. This is the page number 41. This is the method. It is used to separate each and every component of the mixture. I repeat, floating and sinking method is used to separate the each and every component of a mixture. And the components or the substance of the mixture must be solid in nature. This is the first condition. And the one component of the mixture must float over the water and another one must sink in the water. These are the three preconditions in order to use this method of floating and sinking to separate the components from the mixture. Now we can take the real example of this using method, floating and sinking method, to separate the components of the mixture. We know that in our home, while we are going to prepare the rice or pulse for cooking purpose, the food grains include many types of impurities such as straw or the dust. Now the question is, how can we remove the dust or the straw in form of impurities? In order to remove the dust and the straws from the food grains, we must have to first place the mixture. Mixture means the food grains including the dust and the straw in the clean water. And for this purpose of separating the impurities such as dust and the straw from the food grains, we have to apply the science of floating and the sinking method. As we know that the food grains or the pearls are heavier in nature, that's why they will sink in the water. Including the fine dust particles, they may also get suspended in the water. But the straw or the any husk impurities which are present on the food grains, they will float on the water. And here the process decantation. Decantation is a process of pouring out of the impurities from the sedimentation. I repeat, decantation, it is the process of pouring out of the water or liquid in order to separate the substances from the mixture. So in this case, the decantation is used to separate the floating impurities such as straw and the husk along with the muddy water. And finally, we will get the clean food grains which will be left behind in the mixture. We can take also the another example of the mixture, that is the solution, sugar solution. Always remind that solution, the sugar solution, it is the transparent solution and it is not the suspension or the sedimentation. The reason is the solute, the sugar crystals are fully dissolved in the water, and for this reason it makes the clear transparent solution known as the sugar water solution. And in this case, the sugar water solution, the sugar crystals are treated as the solute and solvent it water molecule, clear, and the solution is the sugar water solution. And to separate the sugar crystals which have been fully dissolved in the water and disappeared, we can use the process of evaporation. This evaporation process can be used to separate the sugar molecule or the sugar crystals from the water. We can take another example of mixture that is known as the chalk water mixture, and it is the not the solution but it is the suspension of chalk. The reason is the particles of chalk remain separated in this suspension. And why it is not solution? Because the chalk particles are not fully dissolved in water, and for this reason they produce the milky non-transparent type of mixture, and that is known as the suspension, where the chalk particles get settled down at the bottom of the mixture. And the mixer is the chalk particles along with the water. Therefore, we can say the chalk along with the water is the mixture which may be treated as the suspension of the chalk particles but not the solution of the chalk. Here the chalk particles are impurities and they get settled down at the bottom of the mixture, and the chalk particles remain suspended in the water. Now we can easily separate the chalk particles from the water by using the separation method. As we know that chalk particles don't dissolve fully in the water, that's why chalk is the solute, but it is insoluble solute in the water. Mind it, sugar is the soluble solute in the water, but chalk is the insoluble solute in the water. The reason is as they don't fully get dissolved in the water. They produce the suspension but not the solution, and they also generate the sediments in the water at the bottom level of the chalk and water mixture. Now we can take also the another example of suspension, that is the milk water suspension. Milk water suspension is also the suspension, one kind of mixture, but it is not the solution. The reason is similar to the chalk, because the protein, fat and the calcium, these are the particles which remain suspended in the water. They are not fully dissolved in the water. That's why whenever milk is added to the water, they produce the milky type of suspension but not the solution. Sea water is the example of mixture. The reason is the sea water is a solution. Now see, sea water is a solution but not the suspension. That is answer. The reason is the different salts get dissolved fully in the sea water and they produce the saline. And this now see, and these different salts are solutes, but they are soluble solutes. That's why they produce the solution of water and the different salts, and this is the seawater mixture. And in this seawater mixture, impurities may also present, and these impurities get suspended but not dissolved, mind it. This is the activity we can perform in order to properly understand how to separate the sugar and the sand from the mixture. And for doing so, we have to first require some materials such as clean water, mixture of sugar and the sand. And the process is, we have to first add the sugar and the sand with the clean water so that we can have the mixture of water, sugar and the sand. Now, as we know, sugar, these are the soluble solute, they get dissolved fully in the water, but the sand, they are insoluble solute, they don't get fully dissolved in the water. They actually insoluble in water, and as they are very heavier than the water, they sink in the water. Now the solution, sugar solution, sugar solution means sugar along with the water that is to be poured out or decanted into the another vessel so that the sand is left behind. And how can we get the sugar? The answer is on evaporating process. This is the method of separating the substances from the mixture. This is the process of separating the sugar solute from the sugar solution. We can use this evaporation process to separate the sugar solute from the sugar solution. Now we can finally conclude or observe that sand, we know, being insoluble in water, that's why they sink and left behind at the bottom of the mixture, clear, at the vessel. But sugar is fully, as we know, dissolved in water, and they can be separated by using the process of evaporation. Now we have to know the different meaning of the different terms, such as what is the sediments. Sediments are, always remember, they are the mainly insoluble but not soluble. Sediments are insoluble solid particles which settle down in the water. Sediments are the not soluble but insoluble solid particles which settle down in the water. Sedimentation, it is the process of insoluble solid settling down at the bottom of water. I repeat, sedimentation, it is the process of settling down of the solid insoluble particle, or we can say the sediments, in the water. Now, what is the decantation? Decantation, it is the process of pouring out of the liquid or water from the sediments of the mixture. Decantation, it is the process of pouring out of the liquid or water from the mixture so that we can separate the sediments from the mixture or from the water. Now, what is solute? As I mentioned earlier, these are the substances which are soluble either partially or fully in the water. And solute can be categorized into two, such as soluble solutes. They are fully dissolved in water, insoluble solutes not dissolved in water. What are the examples? Sugar is the soluble solute, salt is the soluble solute, sand is not the soluble solute, they are the insoluble solute. Solvent is the liquid part of the mixture in which the solute get dissolved, and the ideal example of the solvent is the water. And what is solution? It is the mixture of both the solvent and the solute. And the solution may be the transparent, translucent or the opaque type of solution. And we must have know also the difference between the solution and the suspension. Suspension is the transparent, not transparent, but translucent or the opaque type of mixture, where the solute don't fully dissolve, but solution is the transparent maybe, or the translucent type of mixture, where the solution or the solutes may dissolve or not fully dissolve. Solution may be the homogeneous or the heterogeneous type of. Clear? These are the basic differences between the solution and the suspension. The main difference is, in the suspension, mainly the solutes don't dissolve, but in the solution, the solutes may dissolve. We can take the example of the transparent mixture of solution, such as the sugar water solution. But wax water solution, wax is not soluble in the water. That means they will not produce the solution. Clear? But always remember that wax, although it is not soluble in water, but they can be soluble in the kerosene. And for wax, kerosene is treated as the solvent for the wax. Always remind this one. Kerosene is the solvent for wax, as wax is not soluble in water. Sand as insoluble solute, they mainly settle down as the form in the form of sediment in the mixture. And always mind it that sugar is always obtained by the process of evaporation by separating the sugar solution by the decantation process. Now we have to know what is the decantation, the sedimentation process. This is the chart of the decantation. This is the this is the activity we can consult, or we can go through for understanding clearly the sedimentation, the decantation process. First of all, we have to know that this sedimentation, decantation, the evaporation, these are the processes which are used to separate the substances from the mixture. This is the first thing we have to keep in mind. Now, this is the dirt water, this is the mixture. And in order to perform this activity, we must have water, sawdust and the sand. And after adding the saw water, sand, dust along with the water, we will have such kind of dirty water mixture in the beaker. Now, the procedure is, after preparing this dirty water, the mixture, we have to allow this mixture for some time so that the sand is the sediment, clear? It takes some time for settle down in the at the bottom of the mixture. As we know, sands never float in the water. They sink in the water. That's why they will be treated as the sediment in the mixture, and they will settle down at the bottom of the mixture. You can consider this is the sawdust. Now, sawdust is the lighter one, and they float over the water surface. Clear? Sawdust float on the surface of the water. In this beaker, the sedimentation process is happened. Why? The reason is sand in form of insoluble solute, they don't get dissolved in the mixture of the water. That's why they sink in the water and settle down at the bottom of the mixture. But the sawdust float on the surface of the water. And this one is the final method of separating the substance. This is the decantation process, and in this process we can easily separate the sawdust and the sands, and we can also get the clear water. This is the clean water, this is the sediments of the sands, and this is the cloth where the sawdust remain. And in order to perform the decantation, this is the process of pouring out of the water. First, we have the liquid along with the floating sawdust is to be poured into this beaker. And this beaker is covered with the with a piece of the fine cotton cloth, and by taking care so that the sediments of the sand are not disturbed. Sawdust is left behind on the cotton. Here, cotton cloth, sawdust will be left behind on this cloth, and the clean water passing this fine cloth, the water comes into this beaker, and sand is obtained by the process of sedimentation in this beaker. This is how we can use the process of sedimentation and the decantation to separate the substances from the mixture. And finally, we can conclude that the sawdust, which are lighter, float on the water, but sand, which are heavier, solid particles, they are insoluble in water, and sawdust can float on the water surface, and as the sand particles are heavier than water, that's why they sink in the water. And sedimentation and decantation are the methods which will be used to separate the different substances from the mixture. Thanks for watching.